our next speaker. She's an artist and fashionista. She joined Toastmasters in 1976. And can we tell how many years it took her to become a DTM?
Five.
Six? Seven?
Three? Eight?
It took her 10 years to become a DTM. And I would like to again say the word of the day, Sanford. Please sit down and everybody snap. The title of Mary's speech tonight is Me and Toastmasters. Please give a huge round of applause for our DTM, Mary Francis.
I became aware of Toastmasters when I came down to Florida to visit my mother and the family for Christmas, different time. And Joan was already a Toastmaster here at 1810. And every time I'd come down to visit family, she'd say, come on over to our Toastmaster club and visit. I did, several times, and every time it was such a pleasant experience. You were so cheerful and so warm and so welcoming. It just has a pervasive atmosphere of being so comfortable and so accepted. I was delighted with my visits here. So impressed was I that as soon as I got back to Georgia, I promised myself that I would find a Toastmaster club. So my first Toastmaster club, and the only one I joined besides this one, was Sandy Springs Toastmasters in Atlanta, Georgia. I found another group, a little smaller than you guys, but one that was equally charming, witty, professional, just like the kind of people I would like to become. My first speech was, I was fired up for. I had put all the facts together about my life, and I remember one statement I said during that, toward the end of that speech, and I said, and I'm a mother of three teenagers. Just to let you know how old I am, those teenagers are now in their 50s. That's how long I've been a Toastmaster. It was great. It was great being the club. But I couldn't stop with one speech. I had to give another speech. And the title of that speech, or the purpose of that speech, is different than what's in the book now. It was something that worried me. That gave me a sense of panic. It's like, what have you got to give, or what is your contribution, or what is your special ambition? It was something like that. And I thought, and I thought, and I couldn't come up with anything. And I became panicked. I became frightened. I became frazzled. And I started speaking about how I felt about myself. And I pictured myself as a piece of paper all crumpled up and on the floor. That was my speech during the topic of my second speech. Well, with time, I gained a little more confidence. I didn't feel quite so bad. But I challenged myself because I wanted to be in the speech contest. And I'm telling you, you've got sharp people here, you've got sharp people in Georgia, but when you get ready for a speech contest, it is scary. It is so scary that you just tremble because you think you're not going to feel at all capable of holding your own with the rest of those fine, smooth, professional people. You get scared stiff. I got scared stiff. Maybe you don't. Maybe you're more confident than me. But that was a trying thing for me. But I did make it up to division and then once to district, so I mastered that. But my Toastmaster career went on to other things. I became a district officer. I became first an area governor, which I absolutely loved because I loved visiting all the fun Toastmaster clubs and the witty and the fine people that were in all the Toastmaster clubs. And then I became a district officer, and I moved all the way up. And just before obtaining the district officer, they decided that they were going to award me Toastmaster of the Year. I have felt so proud. It was just like so special. And I just thought, I've done it. I mastered it. I'm okay. You know, I'm there. I'm good enough to be with the rest of my fine friends. And then I moved up and became district governor for a period of time. The nice thing about Toastmasters is that you do grow and you develop. I came here to join your club, enjoying the same ambiance and the same warmth and acceptance, no matter how poorly I performed, or how stiff I felt, or how serious I was. You saw, you all accepted me. So from all of that, I have learned that I am an individual, and that I have arrived at a period of contentment in my life that makes me feel secure and comfortable, and that it's all possible because I have the support of such fine people, such warm and friendly and colorful individuals, that I am part of your community and you are part of mine. So that even though I am 80 years old and pretty crotchety, you have not eliminated me from your membership and I still survive.
Thank you, Mary.